I'm Jens Ziegler and I'm a PhD student at the Otto von Guericke University in Magdeburg, and together with students and colleagues from the medical faculty and the research group INGER and STIMULATE, we present a machine learning approach towards fatty liver disease detection in liver ultrasound images. The background is that fatty liver is more prominent these days in the world's population, and fatty liver disease indicates an imbalance of the metabolic system, which is caused, for example, by unhealthy diet, drug abuse, or genetic reasons, and many more. This imbalance could cause cardiovascular diseases, further also liver inflammation, and could involve to liver cirrhosis, and furthermore to neoplasm, which is the growth of tumors. So detection and the specification of the fatty liver disease is really beneficial, so that you get an early and best adapted treatment. So the first modality to observe a fatty liver is ultrasound imaging, which is more common because of low cost and non-invasive, but it needs quite an experienced physician to give a good diagnose, and which leads us also to a problem, which means it's more subjective and the measure of the diagnosis is mainly qualitative. So we had the idea to develop a computer-aided diagnostic tool to support the physician's diagnosis. And the main reason is to make more objective decisions in using ultrasound images. Some work has shown that the detection of diffuse liver diseases, for example, partially successful and could definitely help the physicians in a diagnosis. But the stated references of two works, they only give like a single prediction of one ultrasound image. And our idea was to do the predictions in terms of the tissue texture that is shown in the ultrasound image. So a computer-aided diagnostic tool which classifies patches in ultrasound images and using a bimodular model, which means we had the idea to first do the liver segmentation and within the segmentation using texture classification. How this is done is first we started the training the models of the segmentations and classification separately. First with 8 mixed healthy and unhealthy and fatty anonymized patient data sets, and we've got the ground troops from the physicians, from experienced professional sonographers, and these were used for pre-processing because the images came from different modalities and they had to arrange some image normalizations. So first is to put the labels that were coming from the professionals and also from the diagnosis from the medical doctors, and we generate patches all over the images, also overlapping, which means that we can generate more data. In fact, 162,400 patches, and extracting then features in total 90, which of 84 features came from wavelet transforms with different wavelets like Harlet, Simlet, Koiflet, Biorthogonal, and so on. And for each of these wavelets, we can extract more features. So additionally, we also extracted 6 features from the so-called gray level co-occurrence matrix, which is contrast, similarity, homogeneity, ASM, energy, and correlation. So further on, there was a feature important test done, and then as well with a PCA a reduction, and then to build the classifier and test it and see how the performance looks like. If the performance was not good, so we rearranged, and mainly we adjusted the patch sizes and classifier parameters and also some features. So at the end, we figured out that 30 times 30 pixels gave the best results, just for further results ahead. And the classifiers were then chosen with random forest with a maximum depth of 10. But of course, we also have used different classifiers like SVN and linear, and also polynomial and K and N classifiers, which random forest with a maximum depth of 10 was the best. Further on, then we trained the classification, which is then giving the labels of the image data as healthy and fatty, and repeated with different kind of features, also from the Wavelet and GLCM, and adjusting again the patch size and see what's the best choice for the classification part. And together we put this in a whole prediction at the end for new data sets. Like we have done five mixed healthy and fatty liver patient data with 81,200 overlapping patches with the same 30 times 30 pixels extraction. And the segmentation part, which was trained before, was then forwarded to the classifier. So it means only the segmented regions were put through, and feature extraction will have been then chosen because of the training data sets, the same features, and then we give a prediction for each single patch in the ultrasound image and visualize them. So as shown in the results, the performance of the segmentations ended up for like background and liver, which means everything that is non-livered was treated as a background and get the color of yellow in the image results you can see here on the right. So the precisions for detecting the background was 0.8 and for liver 0.79, and overall like F score was 0.8. And the accuracy then was 0.81. The performance of the classification, then the next step, for non-fatty was 0.7, with an F score of 0.71, and fatty with 0.74, and overall accuracy of this model 0.71. So as you can see on the top images, so the some of the classification ground truth that was used was not really accurate. So also partially other parts of the liver was not inside of the ground truth, but our model was also detecting these parts, but also parts that are not in the liver. Furthermore, the prediction like on the bottom, so because we're using patches and we also had like the crown truth, some that the major vessels were not included, so the model could also train itself to avoid big vessel structures and give the classification on these parts. So data set was provided unfortunately on JPEG, and so we had to resize the images, and that caused also a kind of loss of the image quality. So we had to negotiate between the image quality, image size, and the classifiers that we at the end have used. So at the end, our pipeline that was consisting of the segmentation and classification was able to at least segment most of the part and give the classification within these segments. But the segmentation was not always nice. So we have to work on the model. So for example, to introduce like liver shape and boundary features to improve the segmentation. So the overlapping patch-based tissue classification attempt needs to be tested with more patient cases, and also with including better image quality. So the amount of data was really low, so the different kind of tissue patterns for healthy and fatty liver was limited. So we're looking forward to test these on DICOM format, and yeah, thank you for your attention, and if you have further questions, we can answer them in the chat, or you can also write an email to the email listed here. Thank you.